Hi there, and welcome to the band. Every year, young students just like you join their school band and start learning a musical instrument. This is an exciting opportunity, and we hope you're looking forward to it. Being part of a band is the same as being part of a sporting team. There are lots of different positions in a sporting team, such as shooter, keeper, or centre. Each position has an important job to do and a set of skills needed to do that job. Just as a sporting team has lots of different positions, your school band also has a lot of different instruments in it. Each instrument has an important job to do and a set of skills needed to do it. Unlike a sporting team though, when you join a school band, you don't get to take it in turns to try out all the different instruments for the first year or two before choosing the one you like the best. When you join the band, you need to choose an instrument to learn right from the very beginning. This might seem hard to do, but we're here to help you. To choose your instrument, it's important that you think about three main things. Which instrument do I like the sound of? Which job do I want to do in the band? And what skills do I need to do that job? So stick around while we show you all the instruments of the band, tell you what their job is, and what skills you need to play them. The flute is the smallest and highest pitched wind instrument in the band. It often gets to play the melody as well as other fast, tricky parts of the music. If you look closely, you can see that the flute has a lot of keys on it, which helps when you have to play lots of fast notes. To work all these keys, you'll need to have fancy fast fingers, or grown-ups will call this fine motor skills. These are the same kind of fingers that would be good at typing on a computer, quickly solving a Rubik's Cube, or working small fiddly gadgets. You'll also need to have good air control to blow the flute, sort of like when you have to gently blow bubbles without bursting them. Making a sound on the flute is a little like blowing across the top of a bottle and can be tricky at first, but with patience and time, you'll get the hang of it. So if you have fancy fast fingers and good air control, and if you do lots of practice at home, you can learn the flute and sound just like this. The clarinet is also a smaller instrument, but unlike the flute, it can play both high and low notes quite well, so it's very versatile. This means it can play both the melody and the harmony parts. Like the flute, it also has lots of keys, so it's good at playing lots of fast notes. This means you will need those fancy fast fingers on clarinet as well. Blowing the clarinet is not quite as tricky as the flute, but the clarinet does have some bigger holes that your fingers need to cover to make the sound, so the size or the thickness of your fingers will be important. If you have average size fingers or bigger, you'll be well suited to the clarinet. We'll talk a little later in the video about how we can help you check your fingers, blowing, and any other skills that you need. So if you have fancy fast fingers that are thick enough to cover the holes, and if you do lots of practice at home, you can learn the clarinet and sound just like this. The saxophone is very similar to the flute and the clarinet. It has lots of keys so it can play fast notes, but is a bit bigger so it plays middle to low notes and usually plays the harmony parts to begin with. Once you get more advanced though, the sax is given the main melody a lot more often, especially when you start playing jazz, rock and pop music. There are four main types of saxophone: soprano, alto, tenor and baritone. The alto sax is the most common and the most suited to beginner students. Although the sax is a little heavier than most instruments, you get given a neck strap to help you hold it up, so it's suitable for most students. It doesn't have holes to cover like the clarinet, but because it is a little bit bigger, you'll need to have fingers that are long enough to reach all of the keys. The good news is that if you're in year three at school and have average size fingers or bigger, you should be fine. Remember, we'll chat later in the video about how we can check your fingers. So if you have fancy fast fingers that are long enough to reach the keys, and if you do lots of practice at home, you can learn the saxophone and sound just like this. Have you found an instrument you like the sound of yet? And do you think you might have some of the skills you need to play it? There are still plenty more instruments for us to look at, but before we do, let's have a listen to the whole band to see if we can spot the flute, clarinet, and saxophone in action. Remember to listen and think about what instrument you like the sound of. There are some that play high sounds and some that play low sounds. Some are loud and some are quiet. They're all important parts of the band though, and help to make the music exciting and full of energy. The trumpet is the smallest and highest pitched brass instrument in the band. It makes quite a strong sound and so is often given the main melody, especially in songs that need to be loud or exciting. You can probably see that the trumpet only has three keys, so fancy fast fingers are not as important on this instrument. Instead, we use our lips and change the way we blow the air to make different notes. Your lips might not be strong enough at first, but you can make them stronger by regular practice. As well as strong lips and good air, students playing the trumpet need to have excellent ears. Grown-ups will call these good oral skills, so that they can hear when they are playing the right note. This is a lot like being able to hear whether you're singing in tune or not. So if you enjoy singing or have been part of the school choir, you might have the right skills to play the trumpet. Last of all, it can be very helpful to have good rhythm and teamwork skills on the trumpet, especially if you want to be a leader in the band. Some people worry that the trumpet might be a little bit too loud at home. Luckily, there's a thing called a practice mute you can put in the end of your trumpet, which blocks up the sound and lets you play it at home as much as you like without bothering anyone in the house. So if you have strong lips, good air, and excellent ears, and if you do lots of practice at home, you can learn the trumpet and sound just like this. Next, I'd like to show you a few instruments all at once. They're called the low brass section. They all have the same job, need pretty much the same skills, and are probably the most important instruments in the whole band. These instruments are all good at playing deep, strong, low notes and play the bass line of the music. Without them, the band can't sound good. And if you play one of these instruments, then your school band will sound awesome thanks to you. Like the trumpet, they don't have many keys to press, so no need for fancy fast fingers. Instead, they need strong lips, good air, and excellent ears. The leader of the low brass section is called the trombone. You can see a trombone in the top left picture where a student is playing an instrument with a big, long, curvy pipe out the front. This curvy pipe is called a slide. Trombones don't have any buttons at all, so definitely don't need fancy fast fingers. Instead, they move their slide in and out to make the tube longer and shorter. This makes the notes go higher and lower. Long arms are helpful, but don't worry. If you're a little short for your age, you can still play the trombone and you'll grow into it. ¶¶ If your arms are short though, or if you don't like the idea of moving a slide in and out, perhaps you'd prefer to play the baritone horn. This is shown in the picture underneath the trombone. The baritone horn is exactly the same as the trombone, except instead of using a slide to change the notes, there are three buttons just like a trumpet. Both of these instruments are excellent for students in Year 3 and play the same important part in the band. Don't worry too much about their size, they're not very heavy, they are hollow after all, and you can get a small luggage trolley to wheel them around on just like a suitcase. Slightly bigger than the trombone and baritone horn is the euphonium. The euphonium is almost exactly the same as the baritone horn, except bigger, and it has a slightly deeper sound. It's still easy enough to play, but a little harder to transport because of its size. Many beginner students start off on the baritone horn and then move on to euphonium once they move into senior band. The tuba is even bigger again, and is not available to learn at all schools. The tuba plays twice as low as the euphonium, so it makes a very powerful bass sound, but it takes a lot of air to blow. Talk to your band director and parents about the tuba if you're interested. The last instrument you can see in our video is a very special instrument called the French horn. The French horn is a little different to the other brass instruments because it can play both low and high notes, which makes it very versatile. To begin with, it plays the middle notes and so is given a lot of the harmony parts along with the saxophones in the band. Like most brass instruments, the French horn only has three main keys, so no need for fancy fast fingers. This also means it will need strong lips, good air, and excellent ears. Not every school has a French horn you can play, and they can be a little bit expensive to buy, so if you're interested in learning this instrument, check with your band director and they can let you know whether it's available at your school. So if you have strong lips, good air, and excellent ears, and if you do lots of practice at home, you can learn one of these important low brass instruments and sound just like this. The bass guitar is different to the regular guitar and is used to help the trombone and baritone horn players in the band. It only has four strings which are played one at a time and not strummed in a chord all together like a regular guitar. To play the bass guitar you need to have a really good sense of rhythm and your fingers need to be a little bit fast and fancy. The bass guitar also suits students who enjoy repetition and patterns. Most schools limit the number of bass guitar players in the band, so it may be best to contact your band conductor before enrolling on the bass guitar. You may need a backup instrument in case there are too many wanting to play bass guitar, and we suggest perhaps trombone or baritone horn would be good backup options since they'll be playing the same music anyhow. So if you have good rhythm, fancy fingers, enjoy repetition and patterns, and if you do lots of practice at home, you can learn the bass guitar and sound just like this. Percussion instruments are a large family of instruments that you play by hitting, shaking, or scraping. Their main job is to give a beat to the music, but they also make other sounds to give the music excitement, suspense, humour, and so on. There are percussion instruments that play the melody, and some that play the bass line as well. There's almost a percussion instrument for every occasion. Students playing a percussion instrument are expected to work as a team and share all the different percussion instruments in the band. To begin with, you'll usually focus on learning the glockenspiel and snare drum, which you can see in the pictures on the left-hand side. You'll also learn some of the basic auxiliary percussion instruments, such as tambourine, cowbell, shakers, and triangle. Once you've mastered the basics on these instruments, you'll usually have the opportunity to start learning the drum kit as well. To play percussion, you have to have a good sense of rhythm, good eye-hand coordination, and be able to multitask, kind of like patting your head and rubbing your tummy at the same time. It also helps if you're super organized, reliable, good at paying attention, enjoy patterns, and repeating the same thing over and over. If you've already played the piano, that would be an enormous help because these skills will help you become a good percussion player. Playing percussion is one of the most challenging jobs in the band, but can be great fun. It suits reliable and dedicated students who enjoy sharing and working as a team. Every school has different expectations about what equipment you need at home to practice and will often have a limit on how many students can play percussion in the band, so check with your band director or TSA office before enrolling for percussion. So if you have good rhythm and coordination, are super organized and enjoy working as a team, and if you practice a lot at home, you can learn percussion and sound just like this. Hopefully by now, you will have seen an instrument that you like the sound of and might be interested in playing in the band next year. Before we talk about how to check your fingers, lips, ears, and other skills, we might watch another quick video of the whole band playing together. While we do, keep your eyes out for your favourite instrument. See if you can hear what it sounds like and what job it's doing in the band. So many awesome instruments to choose from. You might even have a few favourites and need some help deciding. Don't worry, your band director can help, and all you have to do from here is to take home or download the green expression of interest form and show mum or dad. With their permission, we can then meet with you at school and help you find out whether you have the right fingers, lips, ears, and other skills you need for that instrument. It's important that you pick an instrument that you'll enjoy playing though. Having the right fingers, lips, ears, and skills will help, of course, but above all, you need to practice. And if you like the instrument and the job it does in the band, then you'll have more fun and do more practice. So take the time to talk with your parents and your band director to find the instrument that will suit you best. Don't forget to take home or download the green expression of interest note. That note has a link to register your details online, and your band director will then meet with you at school to help choose an instrument. Once you've done that, you can join the band and have fun making music with your friends. Let's finish off with one last song for the band. Thanks again for watching, and welcome to the band.